Matt, welcome to shortlist.com. Thank you so much for meeting us today.
Yeah, thank you.
Congratulations on Dawn. It's an incredible film. Really
thank
enjoyed
you so
it.
Much.
Throughout the film, there is a wonderful tension between the human cast and the apes. I just wondered, was there any kind of tension on set? How did it play off? Were there?
No, I mean, the thing about it is that the cast got along so well. They were all really, you know, one of the nice things is that I think that there was a lot of mystery for me, and I think there is for people who don't know the process, about motion capture. And I think that what people don't realize about the performance capture characters is that really what they all are is just a group of actors. And there's no technical trick to what they're doing. They're just performing while wearing this equipment. And so what I think our human character actors really appreciated was being able to have those amazing actors to play off of. A lot of times when you do a big effects movie, what you're doing is you're having a lot of actors respond to nothing. And in this case, they had Andy Serkis and Toby Kebbell and Karen Carnival and Terry Notary and Nick Thurston. And they were all so emotionally in what they were doing that, you know, actors appreciate when other actors are there for them. So there was no tension between our human and our ape characters. They loved each other.
The visuals are so fantastic that I was almost at a point where I preferred watching the apes.
Uh-huh.
I loved it when they were there and almost was disappointed when the humans came
on
screen. As a director using the performance capture technology, what was that like for you? Were there limitations that you encountered or?
The hard part, I mean, the thing about it was that for me, the exciting part was in the beginning how similar it was to doing anything else I'd ever done. I was worried that somehow it would be an obstacle toward dealing with Andy Serkis, let's say. Like, oh, is there some technical thing that I have to learn that he's doing? And actually the answer was no. You just stage a scene with the actors. And so I would say, Andy, where do you feel like you should stand? And he would start there. I'd say, let's try this. We do that. That was all exactly the same. The hard part was all of the technical stuff that came after you did that initial pass. Then you had to sort of shoot certain shots that he had just done without him, because they take the shots and then put him into that shot.
Mm-hmm.
And then you had to get the human actors to replay certain things that they'd just done without him, and he might talk them through, or I had to talk them through. And that was really unusual. So it was very exciting, and for the most part, as a beginning part, it seemed actually remarkably more like other traditional filming than I would have ever thought. But when you got into the technical part after that, it was incredibly hard, and actually became even more hard when we were editing. So it was, I would say, it's definitely the most challenging thing I've ever done. It was really, really interesting. Because you build a shot character by character, piece by piece. And so in that sense, it's very exciting. You're in post and you can actually create what's in that shot. You shoot the shot on the set, but that shot often doesn't have any actors in it. And you put the actors in it from their reference footage and from going to the volume, recording vignettes of like ape life, like the background. And so every single one of those details is a decision that is decided on.
Mm-hmm.
And it can take months and months and months to put together. And it's complicated, but very rewarding.
We don't mean any harm!
They're apes, man. Do you think they understand what you're saying?
Do they look like just apes to you?
Would you like to use this technology in other genres? Could you see it replacing special effects makeup, or will there always be a place for that?
I think it really depends on the situation. I would definitely, I mean, I loved using it, and I would say that wherever there's an application for it, it should just be used like any other tool. You know, like, you know, people use a crane, you know, because a crane shot, you know, conveys a certain feeling or emotion. And if there's something where you're going to take a character and you want to either anthropomorphize an animal, or you're going to find some way to do, you know, they're motion capture, there's a lot of different applications. And as the technology gets better, as the effects get better and more realistic, there'll be more and more. I mean, you could create human models, and then a character could play someone that he doesn't look like at all. And that would be really exciting, I think, too.
There's already discussion of a sequel.
Yeah.
Do you have ideas already in your mind as to where it will go? Are you seeing another time lapse between this and the next?
I don't know how much of a time lapse there would be yet. We are only just getting into it. I know that it's going to at least start, though, with Caesar, because he's such an integral part to this section of the story. And he's now going to have to engage in a conflict that he desperately didn't want. And he considers himself as much human as he is ape, in a way. And now the idea that somehow the die has been cast is a great tragedy. And I feel like he is, in a way, potentially like the ape Moses or something. He's like a mythic, seminal character for early ape history and putting us on that trajectory toward Planet of the Apes of the 68 film. So it'll definitely start in some way with Caesar.
We really loved your Cloverfield, and we wondered, with films like the Pacific Rim and Godzilla,
right,
really building on the new buzz you put around new modern monster films, does that give you an incentive? Do you want to revisit that with a sequel?
Oh, Cloverfield?
Cloverfield.
Well, we talked about doing a sequel to Cloverfield a long time ago, actually right when we finished, and I think it would be fun to do someday. Sure, absolutely.
And finally, who would you see winning in a battle between the Pacific Rim robots, Godzilla, and your own creation?
I have no idea. I don't know. We'll have to see.
It'd be a good fight, then.
Yeah, that'd be very interesting.
Thank you so much for talking
to
us today.
Thank you. Cool.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Have a good day.
War has begun.